Hi, I'm Helle. Today I will take a closer look at Blackout Hong Kong. I will tell you a bit about the game and what I think about this game. This is a game designed by Alexander Pfister and it's for 1-4 players and it plays in about 75 to 150 minutes and it's for the ages 14 plus. In this game, the lights, they have gone out in Hong Kong. And we need to restore or regain the lights. We need to use specialists and volunteers and wander around gathering resources. First, before I get into what I think about the game, I will just show you something about the game. Each player will start with 12 cards. And these cards are the same for each player. And you have a lot of volunteers that can bring you resources. Blue, red and yellow, and then we have some special characters that have special abilities in the game. But each player will start with the same 12 cards. So each player will start with the same 12 cards. You in the game can gain new cards, new objectives, specialists and volunteers, so you can build your deck, so you can get your deck to be even better. And in each game it will be unique for you. You will get different cards to your hand and you can play the game in different ways. In the game, each player will receive a player board and I think this is a brilliant player board because you can see each of the phases. The start player will control each of the phases, the first phase, the second phase and go up, and you have to go through these 8 phases in each turn. And there's a description for each of the phases so you can remember everything. You just have to read these descriptions and you basically have most of the rules on this player board. And the 8 phases in the game, you will have to, the start player will roll the resource dice and everybody will simultaneously plant cards. And in the second phase, you will deploy your volunteers that you have just played. And in the third phase, you can fulfill some of the objectives on the cards and get some more cards to your hand so your hand will be even better. Or you can fulfill some of these goals and maybe get some checkmark actions you can use in a later phase. And then you can gather a team and go out scouting in Hong Kong and find resources. In the fifth phase, we may acquire new cards. We can buy new cards. And in the sixth phase, we have to clean up. We have to remove some cards. And then we have to secure districts. If any districts have been surrounded by the same color, you may place a house and everyone will score victory points that are present in that region. And in the eighth phase, you can refresh your hand if you have 4 or less cards in your hand, if you want to. And if you do so, you may perform checkmark actions if you have any cards with checkmark actions. And in this game, there are so many things we have to decide for. There are so many different things we can do. If we were in this 8th phase, where we can take cards back to our hand if we only have 4 or less cards. So if I have 4 cards to my hand, I could take this row and place it back to my hand. But I might need the cards in that row, so I might choose not to refresh my hand. And I may make checkmark actions. I can use these abilities on this card. If I had 1 tool, I could exchange it to 2 rice. Or on this one, I could exchange a book to a scout token. So I would be better at scouting. But I can only do these actions if I take refresh my hand. But in this, I really want to make this objective down here where I have to have a row with 2 purple and 2 yellow, and I need 10 coins. I have 9 coins, so I would need 1 more coin. So I might choose not to refresh my hand at this point, because I really need the cards to fulfill this objective. But then again, I might need the cards, because then I might not be able to do what I want to do the next round. There are so many decisions in this game. That was just one. When you have to deploy, you have to plan which cards to use and where the dice they have landed and are they on the resources you need, where to place your cards, in which column do you want to place them, because you might need to have the right colors in the column to fulfill some of these different objectives on the board. And there might be cards that also have some of these, where here we would need to have a red and a yellow in the same column and also 7 coins to fulfill this objective. And you have to oh, there's just so many things you have to decide for. And you can use transport tokens. If now I didn't need any medicine, but I have this one, and I really need some rice, then I could plan to play this card in a column and then use a transport token to go to the rice instead. And I would need one more rice because I need 3 rice to complete that objective. And I need money. I need money so I can complete this objective. So I would need this card. And you have to think of where you place the cards. And I need one more rice. And I only have 2 blue cards left on my hand. I would need to use 3 transport tokens to get over here. Is it worth it? I would get a really, really great card in my hand if I did. I could also use 5 money to buy a resource, a wild resource. But then I wouldn't be able to do this one. Because I really want to do this one, so I would be able to get 4 cards and play 4 cards. There are so many different things you have to think of in this game. So maybe if we played like this, and then when we would go to the deploy phase, we would have to reveal our cards. And I could say, these 2 red, I would like to put them on the rice, and I could give up one of these transport tokens. And then I could take the blue cube and give up 1 transport token. And then now I don't have any more. I can go back 1 point, 2 points and deliver it over here. But it did cost me 2 points to get over here. But I will get an awesome card in the next round. Is it worth it? Ah, decisions, my friends, in this game. There are lots of them. On this one, we would gain 2 coins. And we can give up. And we can give up either a gas or a book. I think we have a book here. We can give up this book resource. And then we can get a scout token. In the next phase, we can complete objectives. And now we have 3 rice. We have 3 rice and 3 tools. It was an expensive card. We will gain this card. And now when I have fulfilled this objective, I may place a cube on a yellow space. And it has to be connected to one of my others. Or I can use a transport token to move it further. In this case, if I don't have any, I could go back 1 point. But I can see I can place it up here. And then I will have closed this area. And I will score something in the secure area. This card I will get to my hand, so now I have an even better card to my hand. So I can build my hand in this way. And this one would give me 3 resources when I play this card. In Blackout Hong Kong, you will play these 8 phases. And you will play until you run out of cards. And then you will finish that round and play 1 more round. The player that at the end of the game will gain most victory points is the winner of the game. In this game, there aren't much player interactions. You kind of build your own deck of cards and you can build it even better and you can build it differently each time you play the game. You can have different things you go for. Maybe you will go a lot for scouting or you will go for getting a lot of these cards with special actions or maybe a lot of people in your hand that can give you a lot of resources, some of these with 3 resources on them, or you will go for some of them that will give you money, special abilities. I mean, there are so many cards in the game. There are so many different ways you can play the game. And you have to build on the map. You have to go scouting. You have to calculate when these resource dice are here. How can you use them the best way to either complete some of your objectives or get some of the people to your hand? And when should you go for these? And when should you pick up cards back to your hand? And maybe you should let them be 1 more turn so you can open one of these abilities, and they will also score you 10 points, so that is also something that is worth getting. There are many different things you can go for, and in some games you might go for both of these, and in another game you won't. You will just go for the cards and build a lot to the board. And these resources, sometimes they won't give you just exactly what you need, but you can then use these transport tokens to get the resources, and instead of getting the water, you can get the book or something else by using these resources. I think that's a great element in the game, so you aren't constrained to that you can't get the books in this round because the die didn't show up. But you can, but so many things you have to plan for and think for in this game. And that is something I really enjoy, that there's a lot of different paths and there's a lot of different strategies you can take in the game. And you have to think how to use what you have in the best way. And you get to build your deck and you get to hire new people or get new objective cards to your hand so you can make your cards even better. This really surprised me on how much I liked the game. I thought I was going to like it, but I really, really enjoyed the game. And the groups that I've played it with have caught up on the game pretty quickly. And these boards you have, where you have all these faces and everything described here, it really works well in this game. I mean, that's awesome. And we can look at another thing at the game. We can look at the components for the game. I mean, the cards, they are a bit dark and they're maybe a little bit dull. They could have been more, they could have maybe done a little better with the cards. And they didn't have to be this dark, I think. The board is dark because the lights, they are out in Hong Kong. But I would have liked that it would have been a bit easier to see these colors where you can build to. Maybe if they have just made a white outline on these instead of a black one, it would have been easier to see these colors. And they could have made them just a little bit brighter. I don't think it would have hurt the game if these colors had been a bit more bright. These money tokens, I mean, they could have been a bit easier to see if it was number one of five. They are a bit dull too, but they work, but they are very grayish and it can be a bit hard to see the numbers on them, but you can see it by the size of them so you know if it's a one or a five coin. These tokens, they are quite all right and these are okay. On this card here, I do think it's a bit hard to see these symbols to find out if this is gasoline, or if it's a book, or what kind of resource is there on this one. I mean, it might be my eyes but I have a problem seeing what these icons they are. I would have loved if they had been just a little bit bigger, so it would have been easier to see the different icons on these emergency plan cards. The gameplay in itself, I really, really enjoy. I love playing this game. I love the challenging, and I have played it as a solo play, two player, three player, and four player, and I think it works in all. Because when you're playing the solo game, and this game, you aren't inflicted that much by the other players. It's kind of you build your own engine, you try to do and score points the best way you can do it. And that's the same if you play the solo, then you will just compete against yourself and see how good you can do in the game. I really enjoy the deck building part of this game and the puzzling part on how to place the cards and which roles to play them and which resources to get in each turn. And you also have the element of where to place the cards, because this card, I really want to get it back to my hand. So if I place it in the cards and in the row or in the column with the most cards, then I will more quickly get it back to my hand. But I also need the colors for the different items on the board. And yeah, there's a lot of decisions going on in this game. And the setup will be different because the cards that will come out here will be different. How you roll the resources, where you start, you have the different emergency plans. And now this game, it wasn't on my most anticipated games for Essenspiel. But it's because this game was announced after I had made my most anticipated games list. I think this might have been on the list if I had known about it before. I did read the rules, skimmed the rules for the game before Essen. And this was the first game I bought at Essen. And I'm not disappointed with the gameplay at all. I really enjoy this game. I do enjoy good worker placement games, and I do also really enjoy the deck building part of this game. And I like that you have lots of different paths and the game won't feel the same each time you play the game, because you will have different cards and you can go for different things in the game, and I look forward to playing it again. So that was my review of Blackout Hong Kong, and yeah, I'm happy with this game, and that's it for me. Thanks for watching.